Until 1944, African American children in Falls Church, Virginia, were educated in a two-room schoolhouse. The building had no indoor plumbing, no indoor restrooms. In the winter, the rooms were heated by a potbelly stove. Used textbooks were handed down from the white schools, and supplies were at a minimum. The disparity between Virginia's funding of schools for white children and the education of black children became the basis of a groundbreaking report compiled by the teacher who would dedicate her life to teaching the students of the two-room schoolhouse. This is the story of Mary Ellen Meriwether Henderson. Mary Ellen Henderson was an educator, activist, and advocate for civil rights and equality. A radiant spirit, her determination and persistence influenced the social and political fabric of Washington, D.C. and Northern Virginia. She was a wife and mother, but it was her dedication to service and becoming a voice for the disenfranchised which led her to become a courageous leader. Mary Ellen Meriwether was born to Mary and James Meriwether on September 18, 1885, in Washington, D.C. Her mother, Mary Louise Meriwether, was a graduate of Oberlin College in Ohio, and her father, James Henry Meriwether, graduated from Howard University Law School and practiced law in Washington, D.C. Both of her parents were committed social activists, and she was influenced by women suffragettes, including writer Anna Julia Cooper and anti-slavery activist Charlotte Grimke. Mary Ellen, nicknamed Nellie, graduated from the M Street School, a D.C. public high school known for its rigorous academic curriculum and high academic achievement. In 1904, she graduated from the Minor Teachers College, then known as the Normal School No. 2, where she met Edwin B. Henderson, whom she would later marry. Edwin B. Henderson, often called E.B., was a handsome and ambitious physical education teacher and athletic director for the D.C. Colored Public Schools. After her graduation, Mary Ellen also began teaching in the public schools of Washington, D.C. E.B. attended Harvard University in 1904, where he studied to become a certified physical educator. While there, he learned the sport of basketball. Henderson saw the potential in the game as a tool for African Americans to prove athletic equality and gain access to college education. In 1910, Edwin B. Henderson and Mary Ellen Meriwether married and were affectionately nicknamed Ned and Nell. On their wedding day, E.B. made the ultimate sacrifice for Nellie. Mary Ellen, fearing for his safety, requested that he give up playing basketball. E.B. then turned his attention to laying the groundwork for black athletics, both for men and women, to play the sport of organized basketball on a wide scale. In the District of Columbia, married women were not allowed to teach in the public schools. Mary Ellen also would sacrifice her career for the love of her husband. E.B. and Mary Ellen moved to Falls Church, Virginia in 1911, where they built a home, grew crops, raised chickens, a cow, and a horse. They had two sons, Edwin and James. E.B. continued to organize physical education in the D.C. public schools. He also fought against racial injustice. He worked to strike an ordinance which would segregate the town of Falls Church. Through this effort, he was pivotal in organizing the first rural chapter of the NAACP. In Falls Church, the schoolhouse for black children was built in 1870. During World War I, the lack of teachers forced the school to close. However, in 1917, members of the community asked Mary Ellen Henderson to reopen the school, serving as principal and teacher. She first refused, not wanting to leave her children home, but the officials provided her with daycare. Mary Ellen answered the call, becoming the school's teacher and principal. She recruited another teacher, Lola Saunders, to teach kindergarten through third grade. Mary Ellen taught fourth through seventh grade. Her students excelled in their studies in spite of the inferior school and poor classroom conditions. The two-room wood frame schoolhouse had no indoor plumbing, no running water, and bathrooms were male and female outhouses. A potbelly stove heated the classrooms, and fresh water was pumped from a nearby well.
We volunteer to go down early in the morning and make the fire with a big old wood stove in there. And I was one of them and come along and made the wood fire and got the classroom started. Make sure we had to go out, had a well outside, take a bucket, go get the water and have fresh and have a dip with that we drank out of.
There wasn't any running water there at all, obviously. And I'm not gonna begin to tell you about the outhouses. But both teachers and students, you know, outside, one for the male, one for the female. Oh, it's terrible.
Her dedication to teaching kept Nellie Henderson at the overcrowded school. As principal, she organized the community effort to raise money for the construction of a new building with indoor plumbing, heating, and better school supplies. But after 20 years of going before the school board, often accompanied by her ally, Mr. Ollie Tenner, another community activist, Nellie Henderson decided to change her tactics. In 1936, she completed a groundbreaking study which showed disparity between educational funding for white and black schools in Fairfax County. The study concluded that white schools receive more than 97 cents of every education dollar for operating funds, better facilities, and books. The Negro schools receive less than 3% for each education dollar, which resulted in no funds for administration, no funds for lunchrooms, no janitorial services, and dilapidated transportation. The report became the basis for legal redress against inequality in the public schools throughout the state of Virginia. After more than 30 years of unrelenting work, her efforts finally paid off. The construction of a new brick building, which contained six classrooms, indoor plumbing, a cafeteria, an auditorium, and a library. The new school was named the James E. Lee School in honor of the African American landowner who donated the land upon which it was built.
I'm glad I lived long enough to see the children getting the fine an education as we had hoped for when we first started out and things looked so dark.
She taught for 30 years. And the whole time she was advocating for a new school. And it wasn't until years later and constantly coming before the school board and asking for a new schoolhouse that they finally awarded her by building a new school, the first new school made out of bricks with running water for an African American school.
Mary Ellen Henderson remained principal at the James E. Lee Elementary School until she retired in 1949. Edwin and Mary Ellen Henderson continued to be active in the struggle for equality. Together, they were members of several organizations, including the NAACP. Mary Ellen Henderson's spirit of advocacy ranged from being the first African American to join the League of Women Voters in Falls Church, being a founding member of the Women's Democratic Club in Fairfax County, to volunteering with the Girl Scouts for 35 years. By 1966, both Ned and Nell decided to move to Tuskegee, Alabama, where they spent the last 10 years of their 66-year marriage living with their youngest son, Dr. James Henderson, and his family. Mary Ellen died in 1976, and her devoted husband, Edwin, who gave up his basketball career for her on their wedding day, died less than 1 year later. In 2005, the Mary Ellen Henderson Middle School in Falls Church, Virginia, was named in honor of this pioneer in education and equality. Renowned portrait artist Simi Knox was commissioned to paint a portrait of Mary Ellen Henderson, which was dedicated as a gift to the new school. Today, the house in Falls Church that E.B. built for his beloved wife Nell and their sons is now the home of their grandson, Edwin B. Henderson, and his wife Nikki. Mary Ellen Meriwether Henderson touched the lives of many. She changed the course of history for African American students in the city of Falls Church and throughout the state of Virginia, and developed a model for achieving equal education for the rest of the nation. The power of the pen. The story of Mary Ellen Henderson.